Morning students, welcome to today's class. Today we are going to do some exercise on a carbon chapter. Okay, here a few questions are there which in today's class which we are going to discuss. Those questions you will find from the parts which we have not done. Okay, but these are very easy and you all know this, like greenhouse gas and all. So you will get to know these are easy. So only this which we are discussing, these are this you need to do, you need to practice. Okay, it's not that those chapters, those parts again you have to do from the book. It's not that the things which already told, the parts or the topics which already told, that will be there in the exam only. But with this, along with this, these questions are also there, these exercises. So you just do practice these things. Okay. So first of all, we will do some true false. State whether the following statements are true or false. So I'm just telling this in worksheet and in study material also you are going to get this. So just answers I will be writing in the board. Okay, so the full sentence I'm not going to write. Just listen to me carefully the question. Diamond, here we have to say whether the statement is true or false. So the first one is, diamond is a non-conductor of electricity but a good conductor of heat. Okay, so it is true, diamond is a bad conductor of electricity as there are no such loosely bound electrons or extra electrons are there. It's not there in diamond, but it's a good conductor of heat. Okay, so it is true. So let us write down the answer. The first one, so as it is given, question number B1, it will be true. Okay, in worksheet and in study material also you are going to get this. So just from that, you follow that. Okay, the next question is, coal is formed by decomposing and carbonizing the fossils which are buried deep in the earth over million of years. Okay, this is true, of course. Coal is formed by decomposing and carbonizing the fossils which are buried deep in the earth over millions of years. Yes, this is absolutely true. So let us write down. I am getting many phone calls. Few students are asking that which chapters will be there in the which topics will be there in the exam and all regarding the syllabus. So several times I told that you follow the class. Okay, you follow the video class. In video class I have shared everything, which things and how the questions will come, everything has been discussed. So you please follow the classes. Okay, you will get all the answers there. Next, lubricating oils are mainly used to reduce the friction between any two surfaces. Okay, in detail we have not done this, which I told before. Okay, so lubricating oil, we know one of the use of graphite is as lubricating oil or as lubricant we are using that. So in different machines and all where this when the machine runs, no, simultaneously two machines are there or two surfaces are there which may touch each which are touching each other, and for that they are having friction between them. Okay, and for that there may be decaying of this or the surfaces. So to reduce that or to remove the this what happens there, okay, we use this lubricating oil or grease or these things, and these are all for this purpose only, to reduce the friction between them. Okay, so this is only it is told that lubricating oil are mainly used to reduce the friction between any two surfaces. Okay, so this is also true. Lubricating oil we are using for this purpose only, so this will be true. Acha, this is question number 4. Question number 3 we have omitted as it involves the variety of coal there. So the question was bituminous is the purest form of coal. So as we have not done this, that's why this is omitted. Next, question number 5. Graphite has a rectangular arrangement of molecules. This is false. We know graphite is having a hexagonal structure. This is the structure for graphite. Okay, this is not rectangular structure, this is a hexagonal structure. So this one will be false, which is written that graphite has a rectangular arrangement of molecules. So this will be false. So question number 5, this is false. Number 6, helium is a greenhouse gas. So this is false. Helium is not a greenhouse gas. It will be carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. So this is again false. Next, carbon monoxide is a poisonous gas. This is true. This is absolutely true. So carbon monoxide is a poisonous gas. This will be correct, true. Next, question number 8. The phenomenon of increasing the temperature on the surface of the earth is called global warming. Okay, this is true. See, this part, global warming, we have not done. But this one, this question is, you know, several times we have done this in geography you have done, or in lower classes also you have read about this global warming. So this is a very simple question. So that's why I have not omitted that. Okay, so don't say that this part we have not done and you are giving question from this. Don't say this. Okay, so but it's not that part again you have to read. It's not that, only this question you do. Okay, so the question is, the phenomenon of increasing the temperature on the surface of the earth is called global warming. Yes, this is true of. Question number 8. Again, this is true. So next we are going to do fill in the blanks. So this was question number B. So the first one is carbon is the 15th carbon is the dash most abundant element found in the earth crust. Carbon is the dash most abundant element found in the earth crust. So this will be carbon is the 15th most abundant element found in earth crust. Okay, so this will be 15th. Question number C1. Next, state carbon is present as coal, diamond and graphite. So coal, this is a, though this we have read in the amorphous form, but as this is a solid, okay, as this is a solid and having a shape, okay, a particular shape, so and diamond along with this coal, diamond and graphite is also there. So these are crystalline allotropes of carbon. So here we will be telling this as crystalline. So in a crystalline state, carbon is present as coal, diamond and graphite. Okay, so coal is not powdery form, no, so that's why we are taking it as crystalline. Next, the dash number of carbon is 6. So we know atomic number of carbon is 6. C6 we write. So this will be atomic. Its mass number is 12. Okay, and atomic number is 6. So this will be atomic. Next, dash is a liquid which contains a mixture of a number of various carbon compounds. So give attention to this question. Dash is a liquid which contains a mixture of a number of various carbon compounds, or various carbon compounds mixture. Okay, so what is that? What is the name? So this will be petroleum. Number 4. liquid which contains a mixture of number of various carbon compounds. Next, question number 5. Dash are different physical forms of an element. So this will be allotropes. The options are given isotopes or allotropes. So allotropes are different physical forms of an element.
So number 5 will be allotropes.
Next, number 6. Dash is also known as buckyballs. So we know fullerene is called buckyballs.
So this will be buckyballs. So this will be fullerene.
Fullerenes are also called, also known as fullerene, are also known as buckyballs. Okay, so these two, when they, you just revise these things, and these questions are there only. I want to tell you all that the parts which we have omitted, that will remain omitted only from this part. If few questions are there, that question only you do. Okay, so in this way, and today up to this, next day we will go for some other chapter maybe, or we can do some other questions also from this chapter. Okay, so till then, take care and keep reading.